In this session, we will study about the turn-off methods or commutation methods of SCR. In the previous video, we studied about the triggering methods. Okay, a thyristor can be turned on by triggering gate terminal with low voltage short duration pulse, but after turning on, it will conduct continuously until the SCR is reverse biased or the load current becomes zero. This continuous conduction of thyristor causes problems in some applications. So the process used for turning off a thyristor is called as commutation. By the commutation process, the thyristor or SCR operating mode is changed from forward conducting mode to forward blocking mode. So the thyristor commutation methods or thyristor commutation techniques are used to turn off the thyristor. What are the methods? So there are two methods basically, natural commutation and forced commutation. Okay, we will see one by one. First one is natural commutation. So generally, if we consider the AC supply, the current will flow through the zero crossing. Okay, after finishing the positive off cycle, then it will cross the zero, then in negative off cycle. Okay, so the current will flow through the zero crossing line while going from the positive peak to the negative peak. Thus, the reverse voltage will appear across the device. Okay, and the reverse voltage appears across the device simultaneously, which will turn off the thyristor immediately. This process is called as natural commutation. Okay, since the thyristor is turned off naturally without using any external components or circuits for commutation. Okay, so this natural commutation can be observed in AC voltage controllers, phase controlled rectifiers and cycloconverters, etc. So this is about natural commutation. The next type is forced commutation. The thyristor can be turned off by reverse biasing the SCR or by using active or passive components. Thyristor current can be reduced to a low value below the value of holding current. Since the thyristor is turned off forcibly, that is, we force the thyristor to turn off, it is termed as forced commutation process. Okay, the basic electronics and electrical components like inductance and capacitance are used as commutating elements for commutation purpose. Forced commutation can be used while using DC supply. Hence, it is also called as DC commutation. The external circuit used for forced commutation process is called as commutation circuit, and the elements used in this circuit are called as commutating elements. Okay, so there are classifications in forced commutation: class A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, in class A, the SCR is self-commutated by a resonating load. In class B, SCR is self-commutated by an LC circuit. In class C, C or LC. Okay, C means here the capacitance, L means L. So C or LC switched by another load carrying SCR. In class D, C or LC are switched by an auxiliary SCR. In class E, an external pulse transformer is used for commutation. In class F, AC, it is also called as AC line commutation. So first one is class A commutation. Okay, it is also called as current commutation. So here the SCR is self-commutated by a resonating load. So it is one of the frequently used thyristor commutation techniques. If the thyristor or SCR is triggered or turned on, then anode current will flow by charging the capacitor C. Okay, the second order underdamped circuit. The second order underdamped circuit is formed by the inductor, okay, by this inductor, capacitor and resistor. Okay, if the current builds up through SCR and completes the off cycle, then the inductor current will flow through the SCR in the reverse direction. Okay, the inductor current will flow through the SCR in the reverse direction. Okay, see here, this is the reverse voltage which is applied across this SCR. So due to this reverse current, this SCR will be turned off. Okay, so after thyristor commutation or turning off the thyristor, the capacitor will start discharging from its peak value through the resistor. Okay, then so the thyristor will be in reverse biased condition until the capacitor voltage again returns to the supply voltage level. Okay, until it reaches it is charged to the supply voltage, this SCR will be in the reverse biased condition. Okay, so this is about class A commutation. Okay, second one is class B commutation. Here the SCR is self commutated by an LC circuit. So the main difference between the class A and class B thyristor commutation technique is that the LC component, okay, the LC component is connected in series with the thyristor in class A. Okay, here it is connected in parallel with the thyristor. See here, in class A, this LC circuit is connected in series with this thyristor. Okay, series with this thyristor. But here in this case, the LC circuit is connected in parallel with the thyristor. Okay, so before triggering on the SCR, the capacitor is charged up. Okay, with the upper plate positive. If the SCR is triggered, okay, then the resulting current has two components. Okay, what are they? First one is the constant load current flowing through RL load. Okay, so first current is flowing through this RL load. Okay, next one is sinusoidal current. Okay, if sinusoidal current flows through the resonant LC circuit, okay, through this, okay, LC circuit. Then the capacitor is charged up with the negative upper plate. Okay, upper plate is negative. Then the total current flowing through the SCR becomes zero. Okay, because of this negative upper plate, so the total current becomes zero. Total current through this SCR becomes zero with reverse current flowing through the SCR opposing the load current. Okay, so if the resonant circuit current, this current, okay, the resonant circuit current, otherwise reverse current, becomes just greater than the load current. Okay, there are two currents I said. Okay, first current is load current, second current is resonant current. If the resonant current becomes just greater than this load current, then the SCR will be turned off. Okay, then the SCR will be turned off. See here, this is the conduction of the SCR. So in this negative off cycle, negative, since the negative voltage is applied, there is no conduction of the SCR, it is turned off. Next one is class C commutation. So here the SCR is commutated in such a way that the C and LC are switched by another load carrying SCR. Okay, in the above thyristor commutation techniques, we understood that only one SCR, but in this class C commutation technique of thyristor, there will be two thyristors. Okay, so in class A, class B, we used only one thyristor. Here we are using two thyristors. So one SCR is considered as main thyristor, okay, or main SCR, and another one is auxiliary thyristor. So in this classifications, both may act as main SCRs or main thyristors. Okay, so we can use both SCRs also as main SCRs carrying load current, and they can be designed with four SCRs also with load across the capacitor. Okay, we can use instead of two SCRs, we can use four SCRs also with load in parallel with this capacitor. If the SCR2 is triggered, okay, if the SCR2 is triggered, then the capacitor will be charged up. Okay, if SCR1 is triggered, then the capacitor will discharge, and this discharging current of This capacitor will oppose the flow of load current of SCR. Okay, so because due to SCR2 the capacitor will charge up, and due to SCR1 the capacitor will discharge. So due to this discharging reversing current, okay, which will be applied to this SCR2 and it will be turned off. Okay, so this is about the class C commutation. Next one is class D commutation. Okay, so in this LC or C are switched by an axillary SCR. Okay, so the class C and class D thyristor commutation techniques both can be differentiated with the load current. Okay, here the load current is the difference. So only one of the SCRs will carry the load current. Okay, in that case both SCRs may act as a main SCRs and will carry the load current, but in this case only one SCR will carry the load current while the other will act as an axillary thyristor. Okay, here this is the main thyristor and this is an axillary thyristor. The axillary thyristor consists of resistor, okay, in its anode, which is having resistance of approximately 10 times the load resistance. So by triggering the axillary thyristor, the capacitor is charged up. Okay, by triggering this axillary thyristor, this capacitor is charged up to the supply voltage, and then the axillary thyristor will turn off. Okay, once the capacitor is charged up to the supply voltage, this axillary thyristor will be turned off. If there is any extra voltage due to the inductance in the input lines, will be discharged through this diode inductor and load circuit. Okay, through this diode and load circuit it will be discharged the extra voltage. If the main thyristor is triggered, okay, this is the main thyristor, if it is triggered, then the current flow in two paths. Okay, so first path is the commutating current, okay, which will flow through the capacitor and main thyristor, inductance and diode. Okay, so this is the path, the first current path is, first commutating current path is this one. Okay, and next one, second current is load current. Okay, load current which flows through this low. Okay, so like this there are two current paths. If the charge on the capacitor is reversed, okay, if the charge on the capacitor is reversed and held at that level using the diode, okay, using the diode, it is, the reverse voltage is kept held at that same level. Okay, then what will happen, axillary thyristor is re-triggered, then the voltage across the capacitor will appear across the main thyristor via this axillary thyristor. Okay, so thus due to this reverse voltage the SCR will be turned off. So this is about class D commutation. Next one is class E commutation, that is in this external pulse transformer is used for commutation. Okay, so the transformer which cannot saturate and capable to carry the load current with a small voltage drop is used. If the thyristor, okay, or SCR is triggered, then the current will flow through the load and this pulse transformer. Okay, here an external pulse generator is used to generate a positive pulse which is applied to the gate of this SCR through this pulse transformer. Okay, through this pulse transformer the capacitor C is charged. Okay, the capacitor is charged around 1 volt and it is considered to have a zero impedance for the turn off pulse duration. So the voltage across the thyristor is reversed by the pulse from the electrical transformer. Okay, the voltage across this SCR is reversed by using the pulse transformer. Okay, pulses from the electrical transformer and this SCR is turned off. So this is about class E commutation. The last one is class F commutation. Okay, in class F thyristor commutation techniques, an alternating voltage is used for supply. Okay, that is AC supply. During the positive off cycle of this supply, load current will flow. Okay, you know the AC signal. So this one, so during positive off cycle, so during the positive off cycle, the load current will flow. If the load is highly inductive, okay, if the load which we use is highly inductive, then the current will remain until the energy stored in the inductive load is dissipated. During the negative off cycle, as the load current becomes zero, okay, during the negative off cycle, the load current will become zero and then the thyristor will turn off. So this is about AC line commutation, otherwise class F commutation. Okay, it is also called as AC line commutation. So these are the commutation techniques of SCR. Thank you.